Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to another video in which we are going to learn about Boolean variables in Dart programming. So guys, this is one of the important data types in Dart programming or any other programming language, that is bool. You can either use the bool keyword or the where keyword as well. So let us understand this with the help of example. It is going to have only two values, that is either it can be a true or a false. So let us understand this with the help of examples over here. So let's say we have a variable option, and then what we will do is 10 less than 15, and then let's put the semicolon, and then let's print this value, that is the value of option is dollar, and then we have option. So I'll save this file and run this code. So I'll clear the screen over here. So as you can see, the value of option is true since 10 is actually less than 15 over here. Let us put another operator over here. Let's say 10 greater than 15. So is 10 greater than 15? No, in this case. So let us save this file and try running this code. So since the value of 10 is not greater than 15, the value of option becomes false over here. And in this way, we can use the values true or false in the Boolean data type. Let us change this where keyword and provide the bool keyword over here. I'll save this file and try running this code. So the same output you should get, that is the value of option is false over here. Guys, this bool data type is very important in programming since whenever you are using the relational operators as well, you can use it in the if condition or the while conditions or any other conditions including the for loops as well. So let us understand this with the help of example. Let's say we have the bool option and then 10 greater than 15. Let us say we have the option over here and then we will print this value. Else, we will print something else. So we will print condition not satisfied and then semicolon. So as you can see, we have the bool option 10 greater than 15. So in this case, it will be false. And then in the if condition, we are using this option, which is already false. So if the option is false over here in the if condition, this print statement will not get executed and the control flow will go in the else part. And then this thing will be printed, that is condition not satisfied. I'll save this file and try running this code. So condition not satisfied is getting printed. Let us say if the option is true. So let's say we have over here 10 less than 15. Save this file and try running this code. So as you can see, the value of option is true. And in this way, it becomes very important that you understand about this bool data type in Dart programming so that you can use these if conditions as well. Another example over here is what we can do is we can put the OR part and then I will put 10 greater than 15 over here. And I will put 10 less than 15 over here. And over here we will put greater than 15. So as you can see, we are providing two conditions. One is 10 less than 15, another one is 10 greater than 15. So guys, what will happen over here is, as you know, in the if condition, any one condition should be true over here in order to go inside this curly braces and execute the series of statements that are provided in the if statement. So what is happening is 10 less than 15, so it is true over here, and then the option that becomes true, and then this line will get printed. I'll save this file and try running this code. So as you can see, the value of option is true, and then what we will do is, let's say I put greater than over here and I'll put less than sign over here. But still guys, what will happen is the option is false, but this condition, that is 10 less than 15, is true. And in this way, the true condition is provided in the if statement and this value of option should get printed. But the value of option will be what? Based on this condition, which is false. So let us save this file and try running this code. So as you can see, the value of option is false. So though it is false, but the other condition, that is 10 less than 15, is true. And in this way, we get the value of option is false printed on the screen. So guys, in this way we can use the bool data type very effectively in the if else statement or else in the for statement, while statements that we have seen in the previous videos as well. So guys, that's it in this video. Please make sure that you like this video so that it reaches to more people, and subscribe to this channel so that you get the notifications on the upcoming videos as well. The next video that we are going to talk about is list and list methods in Dart programming. So stay tuned.